had good time eating the snacks.
Yeah.
We invested a lot in getting them. Okay. So moving on to the specialty of professional speakers, which is to have a power talk in all our meetings. We have a very special gentleman who will be delivering a power talk here. He has the distinction of representing a couple of divisions. A couple of them.
One division
in two district level contests. Adoration Kolkata. And he's one of the shining stars of this club. I'd like to read his formal introduction to let you know a little bit more about him before he delivers his talk. He is a professional engineer with 30 years of experience in infrastructure design and management, like bridges and highways, having worked in several countries. Currently, he is principal design engineer with Floor at Gurgaon. Now, for all of you who do not know much about Floor, his company, they have holidays and Fridays every alternate week. That's something to look forward to. He observes and analyzes variety of things from a different perspective. His long-term speaking goal is to become an entertaining and motivating speaker, to enthrall the audience and to lift them up from somber loneliness and depression. Please help me welcome our Power Talk speaker. Pankaj Prasad is multitasking, multi-taxing, Pankaj Prasad.
Are you all multitasking right now?
Yes.
Good. You all are multitasking. While we are listening to someone, we are still speaking or breathing or digesting our food or pumping blood through our heart in different parts of bodies. So we all are doing multitasking. But why so much of debate on whether we should do multitasking or not? Is multitasking really multitasking? Why we always say no, multitasking is bad? Let's go by the definition of multitasking. We all think multitasking is nothing but ability to do more than one task or activities at a given point of time. Right? But most often not, we refer to multitasking by trying to take a phone call while typing an email or reading a book. And we often blame multitasking because of the constant context switching from one task to another, resulting in huge amount of time loss and performance drops. But we still want to do multitasking, don't we? Despite blaming multitasking in different contexts, right? We all want to have like 5 or 10 different hands. For example, this goddess. We worship multitaskers actually. When you look around the universe, you will see plenty of other examples. For example, the solar system. Do you really see that planets actually moving in sequential order? Despite many people suggest that, no, you should do actually one thing at a time. But if you see all around, there are things which are happening simultaneously. In the companies and the project management context, you will always see people actually trying to squeeze the time by actually making some activities or tasks happen. That's the key to the success in project management. Isn't that true? But why we blame multitasking all the time? You know, when you play an instrument like a guitar, you know, you always have that ability to do two different things at the same time. Your two hands are not doing the same thing. Inspired by our first president, who was probably the ambidextrous person who could write with two hands. One, Mr. V.P. Sharma at Veena Wadi School in Madhya Pradesh started teaching about 300 children how to write with two hands at the same time. And he trained people. And by the time they went to class 3, they were able to write comfortably with two hands at the same time. And by the time they went to class 7 or 8, they were able to write with two hands, with perfect precision and two different scripts. And those scripts also included Urdu and Hindi. See, imagine children writing two scripts at the same time in two different places. Now, what's the history of all this multitasking? Since 1960, researchers have been studying the nature and the extent of multitasking. But broadly, it has evolved around one basic experiment that is called, or that involves actually getting the responses of people to two different stimuli at the same time. And most studies found out that responding to the second stimulus actually slowed down. According to a study by a gentleman who is the head of the neuro section at the National Institute of Neurological Disorder and Stroke, the anterior, most anterior part of our brain actually allows us to leave some activities incomplete and come back to the same position and start all over again. While the Brodmann area 10, which is part of the brain, frontal lobes of the brain, is responsible for establishing and attaining the main objectives in our lives. The anterior parts of the brain actually keep doing multiple tasks till they are complete. In most of the situations, we don't know, but actually, we are not doing actually multitasking at any one point, but we are constantly switching backward and forwards to different tasks, completing one thing or the other. So it appears like we are doing multitasking at the same time, but actually we are doing multitasking at a given block of time. Meyer and Moreno, they studied the phenomenon of multimedia learning, how people do that. And they found out that actually by training, we can all improve in doing multitask activities. The brains of people doing multitasking were scanned, and they found out that the prefrontal cortex of the brain actually quickened its process after the training, and people could really improve in doing the multitasking. But again, the same research also concluded that we are not actually doing the two tasks exactly at the same time. We are doing a little bit of here and there. So even if you are, let's say, breathing or listening to something, you are constantly switching back and forth from one task to another. When it comes to gender, it's a common wisdom and it's present in the media all over the place that women are better multitaskers as compared to the men, right? Mm-hmm. But very little data actually suggested this until recently, when some studies were conducted by Penn Medicine and they found out the major differences between the neural wiring of men and women. Yes, men can be better at doing and learning one task at a time, like for example cycling or maybe map navigation or something, whereas women have shown superior memory and social cognition skills to do multitasking and come up with a solution which works better for the group. There is a hunter-gatherer hypothesis, which says that men mostly, they work like hunters. They will concentrate at one task at a time. They will do hunting. Whereas women, they have the tendency to do gathering. They will do multiple activities or at houses. So that has been well established by some of the recent studies. A group of men and women were given 8 minutes to complete 4 different tasks. To find a restaurant in an app, to respond to a phone call, to do some quick math, and to determine how to discover a lost key in a field. The time allotted was so short that it forced both men and women actually to prioritize and organize the task and keep calm under pressure. And it so happened, after the study, looking at the brain scans and the way they actually try to do the pattern, then women experienced much better performance for how to find a cost of the four tasks. They went all, you know, went in concentric rectangles like this, and they scanned the whole field, and that's the strategy they evolved, and that's the perfect strategy to find something. Whereas most of the men actually couldn't even scan the whole field properly. But as I say, we are not very good at assessing ourselves. Some people, most of the men think that they are better multitaskers than they really are, whereas most of the women think that they are the worst multitaskers than they actually are. Put it simply, if women couldn't multitask, we wouldn't have been here. But we all are terrible multitaskers, men and women alike, when we compare ourselves to our closest relatives, the monkeys. The advent of technology actually fosters multitasking learning pretty fast. You might see that children often combine various forms of media and they keep changing their source of input all the time. Observers of youth in the modern society find that actually the youngest generation, Generation Y and Generation G, they're very good at multimedia, multitasking. So when it comes to public speaking, if you put yourself outside yourself and try to judge your own behavior while speaking, you will find out that actually your attention is also splitting. While speaking, there is one attention which is in your head, which is like looking inward, and the other attention is in the audience, which is like looking outward. So you are doing actually two tasks at the same time. One concerning the listeners and one concerning yourself. Most of us are probably oblivious of the fact that speaking itself is a very complex thing, which involves a perfect coordination of various parts of your body. For example, your lips, your tongue, your jaws, and of course the larynx, the voice box. So we must be mindful that despite blaming and cursing multitasking, actually we are doing it, and we are always trying to improve ourselves to the next level. So I urge all public speakers and all Toastmasters here to use multiple sources, I would say multiple props, PPT and many other things, to make your speech even more powerful, more packed. Especially when you are faced with back-to-back speeches as a professional speaker, use multitasking.